All right, while we are here in Detroit, we figured it would be the perfect time to check in with the all-important voters in this swing state. So we sat down at the Detroit Foundation Hotel with a group of engaged voters, mostly Democrats, one independent, some of whom have volunteered on various campaigns in the past. We wanted to find out what kind of candidate they think can beat Donald Trump. And as you are about to hear, Democrats are wrestling with whether to go bold or practical, progressive or pragmatic. Here is your pulse of the people.
How many of you are still candidate shopping? All of you. Edith, are you leaning towards anyone?
Joe Biden.
For you, Joe Biden is at the top of the ticket.
So far.
And why?
I've watched Joe Biden over the years. I find him to be competent politically, solid in foreign relations, and that he never forgot where he came from. I like that.
I'm going to say the one I'm leaning towards most is Julian Castro, because he has a really good stance on reparations, better than any of the candidates. And then he talks a lot about immigration reform and then a lot about Native people in this country.
I love so many of them. It's almost like an embarrassment of riches because we've got so many wonderful choices. I respect Joe Biden, I respect Bernie Sanders, and they would have been my person last time. But now I feel like we need something besides an old white guy.
Ryan.
So my top candidate right now is Elizabeth Warren. She's not in it just to say that, oh, I'm president. She's in it because she really cares about ordinary people.
For me, what was really important was that my family lost our home in the financial crisis, and Elizabeth Warren really stepped up to the plate and was taking on those big banks and trying to help people like my family.
Say.
Joe Biden. I think that what the country needs now and probably for the next few decades is somebody who can right the ship because the waters are going to get stormier, they're going to get choppier. And the idea of simply replacing one person who's rocking the boat with a person who's going to rock the boat on the other side is probably not wise at this time.
I think a lot of people do support Joe Biden, like my friend here, thinking that because he's moderate that he'll appeal to most people. But I think we've seen from the Republican Party that somebody who wasn't moderate, somebody who was very far right, changing things, trying to change the country. I think to battle against that, we need somebody who's very far left and really supports radical change.
What do you all think about all of the conversations that we've had of late about race?
I think that at his core, 45 is a racist. He came down the steps of Trump Tower, a racist. He rode into the White House, a racist. And he has opened the door for every racist who's been hiding in the corners to come out and show themselves.
I mean, it sounds like you're saying that he didn't start this, he just tapped into it. So how much responsibility do you put on President Trump?
I put all of the responsibility on President Trump. It doesn't matter if it's been there. There has never been a candidate since George Wallace who has exploited it to the extent that Trump has. And it's gonna take us a long time to fix and mend this.
It's not a debate for me on like if he's a racist or not. I think it's very clear that he is. He holds the highest office in the land, and I think he's legitimizing hatred throughout this country, and it really, really shows. And it's a dog whistle to many, many races out there who feel as though they can, you know, say these things and feel like it's okay, but it really isn't.
Since 9/11, being a Muslim American has brought with it its own challenges. And perhaps more historically, the idea of hearing "go back home" has always loomed over me. So I think some of those verbal cues, which seem to be much more benign, happen with much more frequency than somebody actually yelling at you saying, "go back home, you're not welcome here anymore."
And what do you think about the internal squabbles about race in the Democratic Party? Show of hands, how many people think that it's fair game for Democrats to go after each other on past issues of race? So fair game. Why don't you think so, Syed?
You know, it's ironic. Ronald Reagan said that the one golden rule was that Republicans shouldn't go after each other, that they should really circle the wagons. And part of that was recognizing that everyone's got skeletons in their closet. You can go ahead and disagree about politics, you can go ahead and disagree about policy, but dredging up things from the past strips it of its context.
You thought the Kamala Harris going after Joe Biden at the first debate was a low blow?
I think it was a premeditated, scripted low blow, yeah.
I have a story about that, about busing, about being the only black in a school. So I have a story. But I also try to think about what other people bring to the table. And I don't expect them to have the same feelings about it as I do.
How many of you, show of hands, are optimistic that a Democrat will win in 2020? Why don't you think that you have better chances in 2020?
I think that a blind optimism is how we got Trump. People didn't feel like they needed to turn out because they assumed that Trump would lose. We really need a candidate that is going to increase Democratic turnout and not a candidate that's going to convince Trump voters to vote for them, because it's not going to happen.
I'm usually optimistic about a lot of things, but I'm really afraid of this next election. I think a lot of these topics coming up today is that the person who's elected the Democratic nominee, I think that he will go too moderate to think that he's going to get a big base of voters. And while doing that, lose a lot of the people that would have voted for a person that was more passionate, more liberal, more progressive.
We're fighting for what is America and what does America stand for. You've got to have passion about that. If we don't, we're lost.
So that was so interesting and so informative of where the Democrats are. Only one of the voters on that panel said they feel confident. And I think that fear informs everything they said before that. All they want to do is win.
Absolutely. They want to beat Donald Trump. And as you heard, half of them believe only a progressive can do that, somebody who will excite and energize the base. And the other half believe only Joe Biden, somebody that with a proven track record. So there you are.
After 2016, they're not going to take anything for granted.